All right, let's look at another problem with variable versus absorption costing. In this one, we're going to calculate the difference in net operating income between the two methods. But we are going to have to use some problem-solving skills for this particular problem. PDP Ammo Inc. manufactures a single product with stable production and a consistent cost structure from 1 year to the next. For the last 2 years, the company has manufactured 100,000 units and has incurred fixed manufacturing overhead cost equal to $50,000. Sales in year one were 95,000 units and sales in year two were 102,000 units. The company reported net operating income of $60,000 in year two based on variable costing. What is the income reported in year two under absorption costing? All right, so we are focusing on year two, but we do have a stable cost structure, so our cost per unit is not going to change, and we won't have to use FIFO, LIFO, or weighted average for that reason. But you also note that we're trying to find the difference in income, yet we're not given the information to compute an entire income statement. We're not given the sales price, the variable cost per unit. There's some missing information. So what we have to focus on is what is the item that causes the difference in the two methods, variable and absorption costing. Hopefully you said fixed overhead. So let's turn our focus to the fixed overhead cost. We'll calculate the fixed overhead cost per unit for year two. This would actually also be the cost per unit for year one. The fixed overhead per unit will take that $50,000 of total fixed overhead, and in each year we produced 100,000 units. So our fixed overhead per unit is going to be equal to 50 cents per unit. Based on this, we're going to be able to figure out how much fixed overhead is expensed under each of the methods. All right, so the fixed overhead expensed in year two will tell us the dollar difference in income between these two methods, since that is the one item that is treated differently. Under absorption costing, you'll have to compute the amount expensed. In this method, you expense in proportion to sales, and you did sell 102,000 units. So we can compute the amount of fixed overhead expensed by taking the 50 cents per unit and multiplying by 102,000 units. We're going to expense $51,000 of fixed overhead, even though we only incurred $50,000, and that's because we'll be selling some inventory that was produced last year. Now, under variable costing, we simply expense the amount incurred each period, which is the $50,000. So we know there's going to be a $1,000 difference in income. And if you look at this, if you expense more under absorption costing, will income be higher or lower? Anytime you expense more, income will be lower. So absorption costing income will be lower than variable costing income. All right, so we can reconcile the net operating income. What we were told in the original problem is that income under variable costing is $60,000. We just computed that income will be different by $1,000 due to the additional fixed overhead expensed under absorption costing. So we're going to subtract that. And we will find that income under absorption costing will be $59,000. All right, so you're able to focus on the treatment of fixed overhead to find the difference in income or ending inventory under these two methods. If you look back in your notes, you'll see that if sales are greater than production, income will be lower under absorption costing. And this problem simply shows or demonstrates how that plays out. right, that's the end of the problem. Get some practice, bring questions to class if you have them, and I'll see you then.